Det har varit en kul festivalsommar, det vet alla ni som har varit ute. Det finns ett band som alla har snackat otroligt mycket om i sommaren. Kanske till och med lite för mycket med tanke på att man knappt har kunnat höra den. De släppte väl några singlar, sådana här importsinglar i våras någon gång. De har alltså benämnts som rockens stora framtidshopp. Jag pratar om The Strokes.
New York-kvintetten The Strokes, uppskrivna är väl egentligen bara förnamnet.
Kan du höra? Du träffade dem i somras?
Ja, de var och spelade för första gången i Sverige på Acceleratorfestivalen i Malmö, Göteborg och Stockholm. Och musikbyrån åkte till Göteborg.
It's just that, like, sometimes people, like, they meet us and, like, you know, they hear our music and I think they get, like, really excited and they think that, like, we're cool guys and they want their readers to think that we're cool, so they make us seem like we're 10 times cooler than we really are.
Sällan har det varit lättare att ta till ett uttryck som hype, som i fallet med The Strokes. Under våren och sommaren har musikjournalister världen över verkligen gjort sitt bästa för att överrösta varandra i hyllningskören. Redan innan Strokes debutplatta ens var färdiginspelad hade 5 New York-slynglar i 20-årsåldern utsetts till världens coolaste band. Up on a hill, here's where we begin. This little story a long time ago. In the sun, sun, having fun, it's in my blood. I just can't help it, who wants you to see, no, let me go. Oh, let me go, 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 go. Leaving just in time. Do it just to please me. Tomorrow it is different. So I'll pretend. I'm leaving. The hype. Yeah. Don't believe the hype. Yeah, great white hype.
But, I mean, do you feel like that? That you are, like, the next big thing and all this?
I think that's just a journalist who got to hear our record and got so excited about it. And instead of saying like, hey, you know, it's a really cool band, you know, from New York. They play good music. You should check them out. It's a fun, fun show. Like, I don't know, it's a good time. You know, they wrote like this extravagant thing to, you know, sell more copies of their magazine, which is like what their job is, especially in England. I feel like they, you know, they do that. I mean, I'm not saying we're like, what's it called? Like ungrateful. Thank you. I'm grateful for having this press, because I feel like it's gonna. Our goal was to, you know, give our music to as many people as we could. You know, it's really gonna help us out. Last night she said, oh, maybe I feel so down. Oh, it turned me off when I feel left out. So I turn around. I never go. I don't care no more.
We're firm believers of that, man, that like people shouldn't really believe like things that they read or things that people tell them. They should like judge for themselves, like Nikolai said.
Go to Strokes concert or buy the album and then you can say that it's good or it sucks.
Don't even buy it, like tape it off your friend or like, you know, listen to it at your friend's house or something, and then if you like it, go out and buy it, you know? Or check it out on Napster, and if you like what you hear on Napster, then go buy it, you know?
Or come to New York and see
us play. Or, you know, just come to my apartment in New York City, and I'll play it for you there. And if you like it, you can go and buy it.
Which address?
I won't.
Ha ha!
Kevin wants to tackle you, man.
What?
You
want to tackle me?
Oh, Jesus. Take him down, man. Take him down. Take him down, Kevin. Take him down. Take him down.
Man. He's crazy.
Take him down.
With him. That's great, Kevin.
Dude, man. Kevin.
Take him down, man.
Woo! Score one for the Strokes.
What are you aiming for? Is there like a goal with the Strokes? This is what we want to achieve.
Our goal since we were kids was to be good. You know, like when it comes to music, we work pretty hard at it. You know,
it'd be cool if like 20 years down the line from now, you know, we're like hopefully old men, and like people like still talking about it. It's like good music they made. You know, that's much cooler than any cover or anything, or yeah. someone saying, hey, that was great. You know, it's just thing lasting the test of time.
That is like the coolest thing in the world, actually.
The fact that you listen to the Velvet Underground, they came out in 1967, that's 2001.
And then in 2021 or something, there would be a new band sitting here saying, hey, yeah, we listen
yeah.
to the Strokes.
Yeah, listen to the Strokes.
That's like far-fetched. Actually, don't even say that, because you'll jinx the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah, that's
don't even
jinx
talk about that. Now. We try not to think about, like, you know, things like that. Yeah, we're just like...
I'm just saying the idea of making good music that lasts.
En sak som man kan säga nu när vi har pratat så mycket om hypen kring The Strokes är att plattan är bra. Fast jag personligen tycker att det är lite mycket gamla hjältar på den faktiskt.
Ja, alltså stundtals stinker det ju verkligen klassiskt New York och inte minst kanske Velvet Underground, men vadå? Det är ju inte de sämsta referenserna.
Nej, men det kanske bara för att man har hört så mycket om dem också, att man liksom förväntningarna blir för stora.
Ja, man blir ganska lätt skeptisk till musik som man får så här nedkörd i halsen. Man får liksom inte en chans att bilda sin egen uppfattning.
Mm. Och sen kan man också tro att The Strokes är liksom världens största band nu, men det är de ju inte.
Nej, när man läser om dem så framstår de ju lätt som det. Men nej, nej.
Men det är jätteintressant det där då när band går från underjorden till att bli mainstream och vad som räknas som acceptabelt innan det blir som en sellout. Alltså att de blir för stora för sitt eget bästa då.